I'm just a guy who loves Disney and has way too much time on his hands. If anybody from Disney is watching, please don't sue me. I'm here to rate, review, and describe all of your favorite things from the magical world of Disney. I'm File91e, and welcome to my Disney news and reviews. Hello everyone, and welcome to this week's Disney news and reviews. I'm File91e. And a pretty cool week for me this week, guys. A little weird. Sorry I missed last week. I was had to go to a family thing. There was a play up in Pennsylvania, and my little cousin was in it. It was her, not little cousin, she's in high school now, so my cousin was in it. And she, played a part, and I wanted to see it. And it just, with cleaning everything, for spring cleaning and whatnot, I just ran out of time. So that's the guy, like I said, that's the one plus about not having to worry about, or not monetizing or not being, a YouTube, worrying about, revenue and all that stuff from YouTube. I can take some days off and not, worry too much about it. So yeah, that, will happen in the future, but I try not to let it. I have a little gravelly, stuff in my voice only because it's, allergies, and they suck. Allergies suck. The Where in the Land from last, or 2 weeks ago, last time, was the Sarge's Surplus Hut in Cars Land in Disney's California Adventure. So just know that. It's actually a really interesting place if you want any Cars toys. It's a good place to go. I do want to mention the giveaway. It's still going on, so follow the link below if you're into that. It's the Merchandise March giveaway. The drawing will be next week, so it should be fun. Yeah, we have the Avengers coming out, and next week starts movie month, so that should be fun as well. I can't wait to watch the Avengers and then talk to you guys about it. Now, the big thing this week, I told you, if you're following me on my File91e Facebook page, link is in the description box for that. I got a package in the mail that is was a very big surprise from a good friend of mine. John, I saw him when I went to Disneyland, and he's a good buddy of mine. Now he is. After talking with him and everything, you realize just how dedicated to Disney he is, how much he loves it, and how just how much of a great person he is. So when he mentioned to me he might be sending me something, I had no idea what to expect. He went to the Star Wars celebration out there, and he's going to go to the Star Wars weekends when that comes around. He also went to the Pro Bowl. He's very active man. So he wrote a note for me. He said, "Hey, found out when he just finished Star Wars Celebrity Weekend, or Star Wars Celebration rather, I'm sorry. It was a crazy 4 days, but fun as all hell. Got you and Nate some items. Enjoy." And I think this is like the first time anybody's ever sent something for Nate, which is great, because Nathan's a big part of this show, especially helping me and everything. So let me show you this, the stuff he got me. He knows I love freebies, stuff like that. This awesome Star Wars Weekends thing. I'm sure you got that at the Star Wars celebration. They're just getting ready for that. This is really cool. This pamphlet for the Star Wars Weekends. It's like a Boba Fett. It looks so awesome. We got this awesome Star Wars Celebration 2015 pin. So, that's just so cool. He knows I love pins, so that's awesome. I love the fact that it has the date on it because it makes it kind of unique. And then here we go, the Star Wars Celebration Insider Guide, the pamphlet there. It's just really great. The Lego Star Wars Celebration schedule. Just all the schedules and stuff that's in here. I can't wait to really go through this and just check it all out. And the two big things that are just really awesome. One, I said he went to the Pro Bowl. So he got me this official game program from the Pro Bowl. He and I both love football, so it's great. I love the Ravens. He's a huge Kansas City Chiefs fan. So, go Chiefs. So we got Marshawn Lynch right there. There you go. Marshawn Lynch, beast mode! And he's also a Los Angeles Dodgers fan. And I'm an Orioles fan. So, talk about that. It's really cool. And I can't wait to go through that. He also got me the official Star Wars Celebration pamphlet thing here. It looks really great. I mean, really heavy duty stuff. I might actually have to do a video on this, just kind of going through it to show you guys everything in here. I cannot wait to see this. This is just really, really cool. Just awesome, awesome stuff. Now the actual gift he got me, he didn't have to, but he did. He got me this awesome, because I like to grill, and I do plan on doing a grilling with File91e soon. He got me this apron. It says, it appears that you're to be the main course, at a banquet in my honor. That was when C-3PO told, or that's what C-3PO told Han Solo as the Ewoks were about to roast him over a spit. So that's absolutely hilarious. I will wear this for my grilling with File91e session. I might just do burgers, but I will do some other ones, especially over the course of the summer when I go grilling. I love to grill on my little Weber there. Now the big thing you got, and this is Nathan's, it's great. Told Nathan he had to wait a second before he could put it put it up and display it. He got this awesome signature Boba Fett beer stein. Nathan loves Boba Fett. He is just the biggest Boba Fett fan I've ever met. He wants to get a tattoo on his arm of everything. It's just absolutely great. So Nathan is the biggest Boba Fett fan, and I didn't know John knew that. But apparently when I was filming stuff, during the Halloween nights and all that stuff, he and Nate were talking, and they found some common grounds with beer and Star Wars. So this is, this covers both of them, beer and Star Wars. Let me get this out for you. I'll be right back. So yes, beer and Star Wars, amongst other things, But here it is, the Boba Fett beer stein. I mean, just look at the detail on that thing. This is amazing. Right here, this sort of thing. You hold it. Go like that. Nathan loves beer and he loves Boba Fett, so this covers both of them. Nathan does plan on using it at least once, so maybe I'll get a video of that. But this is awesome. Just look how awesome this is. So John, I really want to say I appreciate all of this. This is just fantastic. You did way too much. You didn't have to get me anything, and you definitely didn't have to get Nathan anything. But it's great. It was such a pleasure meeting you out there, and I really have no idea how I'm going to repay you. I mentioned that to him. He said just keep making videos. So I guess I'll just have to keep making videos. I love making videos, and I do it for you guys, and because you guys rock, and I absolutely love it. I never ever want to ask for things like this because I don't know how I can give back. But when you guys go and do something like this for me, it's hard for me to put into words just how much, I appreciate it. It's very awkward for me because I'm not used to, praise like this, it's great. And I love you guys for it. And John, thanks so much for this. You made our week with this. And you didn't have to, but I'm so happy you did. And I'm glad you had a great time with the Star Wars Celebration. I know you're going to have a great time at Star Wars weekends, and I cannot wait to see the pictures, that you get from there. And good Lord, if you got us all this stuff, I can't imagine what you're going to get when you go to the, your first Star Wars weekend. So have fun at Darth's Mall and everything like that. That should be fun. So that's what's been going on with me this past week. Let's get right to the news. It looks as though Disney's Hollywood Studios will be getting a new theater on Sunset Boulevard built in a flex space previously built into the park. A recently filed permit includes plans that outline a new theater space between the Rock and Roller Coaster and Tower of Terror. The backstage area has been previously used to host Darth's Mall during the Star Wars weekends and various events during the old ESPN The Weekend time. The new flex space theater being built may indicate that the park's other flex space, the Premier Theater on Streets of America, may soon be closed. The Frozen sing-along that currently plays in the location is being relocated to the Hyperion Theater, which previously was home to the American Idol experience, so that's where that's moving. The closure of the Premier Theater without a replacement would leave the park short of locations of visiting high school bands and other special events. The development is significant because the Premier Theater sits in a key area that is expected to be used by the major rebuild of the Disney's Hollywood Studios that is expected to be announced in the coming months. So they're really starting here. They're getting permits filed and everything. Some big stuff's going to be going down for Disney's Hollywood Studios soon. We already know that there's going to be a name change to what we don't know. But who knows? It should be pretty fun. Fun, exciting time. Frozen Summer Fun will be returning to Disney's Hollywood Studios this summer, and Disney has put on sale tickets for the Frozen Summer Fun Premium Package. There's been a small price increase, and the dates are from June 17th through September 7th. The package includes reserved seating for a variety of shows and performances, complete with drinks and snacks. So if you want to, I think it's like $79 for the whole day. You get preferred seating and some drinks and snacks during the special things that they have there. So that's pretty fun. The lineup for the 2015 Sounds Like Summer concert series at Epcot is now available. Showtimes are 5:30, 6:45, and 8 p.m. Sounds Like Summer concerts are included with the Epcot admission and take place at the American Gardens Theater in the World Showcase, which is the America Pavilion. To see which performers are playing at what time, follow the link below. It's like cover bands, you know, like for the Eagles and stuff like that. So pretty good stuff if you want to, you know, catch some live music while you're at Epcot and partying out during the summer. Interventions West at Epcot will have its final day of operation on April 29th. With the closure of Interventions West, Think by IBM, The Great Piggy Bank Adventure presented by T. Rowe Price, and Where's the Fire presented by Liberty Mutual Insurance. The Chase Meet and Greet will continue to operate in its existing location. That's a really hard word to say, or phrase to say, at Interventions West beyond April 29th, so it's going to still be there. The meet and greet is exclusively for the Chase Disney Visa credit card holders and provides a complimentary photo pass picture as part of the experience. A new experience is being planned for Interventions West, although Disney has not yet confirmed any details. We just know that that's all going and being opened up, and who knows what they're going to have there. It should be fun. I love the Interventions at Disneyland, and if they could kind of mix in some Marvel stuff or some future stuff like Tony Stark tech and things like that, have it be like a kind of a trade show sort of thing, you know, mix actual stuff with, you know, fantasy stuff, I think they could really make it cool. The refurbishment project at Disney's Animal Kingdom for the Flame Tree Barbecue has been extended through to late May. Originally set to reopen on March 1st, then on April 22nd, the refurbishment is now listed through to May 22nd, reopening to guests on May 23rd. During the refurbishment, some of the Flame Tree dishes are available at nearby kiosks, so who knows, maybe it's just they keep pushing it back, so who knows, maybe they'll do it again. Work is now well underway and on restoring the exterior of the Great Movie Ride at Disney's Hollywood Studios. The reproduction of the Chinese Theater has been obscured by the Sorcerer Mickey Head icon, and when that was removed earlier this year, the exterior was left looking in less than prime condition. It's hard to be in the shadow of that giant hat and still keep up to snuff. So they're really doing some good stuff and making sure that looks awesome. So keep an eye out for that when you go down. And finally, the start date for the refurbishment of Pirates of the Caribbean has been pushed back to June, according to the official Walt Disney World website. The closure was originally scheduled to begin on May 11th, but now has been moved to June 8th. The refurbishment will run through to September 25th, reopening to guests on September 26th. June 8th, that's a big day for me. You know, some of you people know why. So it's kind of a bummer. I love Pirates of the Caribbean. The fact that it's on June 8th is a bummer. But whatever. Moving on, that's the news for this week. Let's get right to the reviews. Alright guys, the first thing I want to review for you today is the Golden Zephyr. Yes, the Golden Zephyr. Now what these guys say the Golden Zephyr is, it's a Zephyr spinning around a central tower. Minor attraction, go but within the first 90 minutes the park is open or just before closing. Totally redundant, can't operate on breezy days. 2 stars. That's actually pretty much it. This attraction opened on February 8th of 2001 and is located in Paradise Pier at Disney's California Adventure. If you veer off to the right when you walk into the Paradise Pier, you'll see it. It's right next to the Jumpin' Jellyfish. And of all the rides in Disney's California Adventure, this is like, I don't want to say the lamest, but it doesn't seem worth it. But I guess because it's Paradise Pier, it's kind of a midway type of thing. This is kind of a midway type of ride, I guess, but, you know, whatever, I understand. Now, this is themed to the Buck Rogers and Flash Gordon style rocket ships. It's basically rocket ships that spin like this. See? They don't go the other way. Nah, they just spin. They keep going. Now, most spinny rides, especially in Disney, you can go up or down, you know, like the Astro Orbiter or Dumbo or that sort of thing. Now, with these guys, you just spin. That's just it. How high you go depends on the centripetal force of the spinning movement, you know, because it's science and stuff. So yeah, this ride was inspired by the Aerostat or the Stratostat ride, which operated at Riverview Park in Chicago. So it's kind of based in old-timey. It's an old-timey ride. That's kind of what it is. It looks nice when when it's lighted up. It's all really nice. That's actually really cool. Now, like they said in the book, this cannot be operated during high winds. And if you know anything about California, sometimes that happens. The fireworks cannot be operated in high winds, and apparently this can't either, because it affects just how things go, because it's just spinning. It's not really controlled by anything. It's the center pole spins, and the things go out, and it just kind of happens that way. So that's it. That is the Golden Zephyr. I took a bunch of video. We didn't really get on it. Because it's a spinny ride, and I really don't think I could fit in it. I didn't want to kind of go for it after our embarrassment at the Silly Symphony Swings. So I just didn't want to deal with that. I don't think I'm missing much, because I've been on Dumbo and the Astro Orbiter, and that's pretty much the same thing, only they're better because they can go up and down while going this way. But this one, not so much. Just spinning. But yeah, that is the Golden Zephyr at the Paradise Pier in Disney's California Adventure. So, the Nate rating. I texted Nate, and I was like, I need a Nate rating and a little comment about the Golden Zephyr. He said, don't remember that ride. Send him a picture. He said, still don't remember that ride. And I said, okay, I will tell them that. So, he doesn't remember it. So, I guess that's a nothing. He gave it a nothing. Or an NA, whatever it is. So yeah, there's an 8 rating for that. So what am I going to give the Golden Zephyr at Disney's California Adventure? It's themed nice, it looks nice, especially when it's all lit up at night. So I'm not going to give it a 1. It is a ride, it is a very, you know, it spins, it, you know, kids might like it. So instead of a 1, I'll give it a 2. I'll agree with them, I'm going to give it 2 stars. It's nothing overtly spectacular. Kids might like to get on it because it is a kid's ride, but it's nothing, you know, worth it. But again, it does look nice when it's all lit up, and it does have an interesting look to it. It would be nice if you could go up or down, but the fact that you can't really kind of inhibits the ride a little bit, takes some of that fun out of it. So yeah, the Golden Zephyr at Disney's California Adventure, 2 stars.
And now, a random Disney fact with File91e.
One of my favorite live-action Disney movies is The Swiss Family Robinson, particularly because the awesome treehouse and the exotic location on which it was filmed. Now, where exactly was this filmed? It was filmed on the island of Tobago in the Caribbean.
And that was a random Disney fact with File91e.
Alright guys, the next thing I want to talk to you about today is the Alice in Wonderland Dark Ride. Now what these guys say the Alice in Wonderland Dark Ride is a track ride in the dark. Oh, whoa, that's a shocker. Minor attraction, go before 11 a.m. or after 5 p.m, good characterization and storyline, 3.5 stars. Now this was one of the things that I wanted to get on, because this is something solely at Disney, one of the things that's solely at Disneyland. And it's not over in Walt Disney World, so you can't really look for it there. It's not even in any of the other Disney parks. And yeah, so there you go. This was built on, it opened on June 14th in 1958, and it's located in Fantasyland in Disneyland. This is kind of right by the Matterhorn. This has gone through several changes over the years. In fact, there is another Alice in Wonderland ride. It's the ever-popular teacups that everybody loves and knows. And it's very weird to have two rides from the same movie. especially when Disney was around. Disney has gone on record as saying he regretted making this ride because it really didn't have the heart of all the other dark rides. There really wasn't a connection with the audience. I can understand that after getting on it. But he made it anyway. It was a ride that they went with anyway because the Alice in Wonderland story was too good to pass up. I do think the teacups are a better ride for Alice in Wonderland because everybody remembers the tea party, and I think it's kind of innovative and stuff like that. And teacups rides are one of the classic rides in Walt Disney World, whereas nobody really talks about the Alice in Wonderland dark ride. But I digress. Anyway, there was a bunch of updates to this ride. In 1983, there was some scenes were eliminated and some were shifted around. For instance, the tea party scene was shifted to the end. They got rid of some of the other ones. And if you don't know what this ride is, it basically takes you through the story of Alice in Wonderland. There are some key scenes in there that you remember from the movie. As the updates have gone on, the technology in there has gotten better and it looks really nice right now. In 1983, also, the Mad Tea Party, which was originally in around the center promenade of Disneyland, was actually moved to the back, right next to this ride to kind of give, I guess, some continuity because, Alice in Wonderland right there, and you go out and you see the teacups, so I guess, they wanted to do that. But alas, whatever. that was just something that they did. There was a bunch of other updates, and in 2014 they added some other digital enhancements and a modified exterior to try to make everything look nice. Disney has gotten better with their dark rides over the years. They've been using fluorescent paints and black lights to kind of give a brighter look to the dark ride, as you're going through, so you're not having to squint the whole time and you actually get some nice big vibrant colors. Like I said, this just takes you through the story in classic Disney dark ride style. So if you've ever been on, Snow White's Scary Adventures or Mr. Toad's Wild Ride or the Peter Pan's, Peter Pan's Flight, it's the same thing. You hop in a little buggy there and you go through and all. It's very zany. You meet Tweedledum and Tweedledee. You meet the Cheshire Cat and the caterpillar. You go through, you meet the Queen of Hearts, you avoid all that, and you go through the story of Alice in Wonderland. Now, one thing that is pretty cool that's a little bit different than some of the dark rides is that it's a two-level thing, so you actually come out in order to go back down and enter the last scene. You go up and then you come outside, and it's nice because it's a little courtyard ride through. There's no scenes to see, you're just outside going down this little winding path. And then you finally go into the last unbirthday scene, the tea party scene, and you exit with that instead of having to deal with the evil queen. So I understand why they reworked it because they wanted to have a nice happy ending. But alas, that's pretty much it. There's nothing really overtly special about this attraction, but it does look nice. And if you like the Alice in Wonderland story, you'll really like it too. Now I do have some footage of it. I want to show you what the attraction is like. I won't show you the whole thing. I might skip some scenes out, but you'll get a good feel of what the attraction is, and I'll come back and give you the Nate rating, and then I'll rate it, and we'll be good. So here it is. It's either Alice's Adventures in Wonderland or at just the Alice in Wonderland dark ride. I'm not sure which it's called, but here it is. Check it out, and I'll come back and rate it. And we'll get that going. Check it out.
I'm late for the important date. I'd like to say hello, goodbye, and may the day.
So there you go. Nothing special, nothing crazy, but it's fun. I love dark rides. That's kind of an essential Disney thing. To me, this was new. I'd never been on an Alice in Wonderland dark ride before. I understand why it's not so popular, or if you compare it to the teacups, it doesn't have that like ooh whatever to it. But it was an enjoyable ride. I didn't mind it. It was something new to me, so it was kind of exciting. Getting on it. So I didn't have the worst time, but again, it's nothing overtly special. So now I asked Nathan, this is the Nate rating, and I asked Nathan what he thought. So let's go right into it. Nathan said, Alice gets a 3.8, because I like Alice in Wonderland. The ride was comfortable and good storybook type ride thing. Basically, he was saying it was a good ride. He enjoyed it, nothing too special, so 3.8 there. So what am I going to give Alice's Adventures in Wonderland, or the Alice in Wonderland dark ride? I'll give it 3. It was, I could push it to a 3.5, but so I'm just going to pull it back. It's a good attraction. Go on it if you want to, or, don't if you don't want to. If you like Alice in Wonderland, this is something you're going to want to hit. The effects look really nice. I like the fact that they got the movies working in there. The bright colors and everything looks nice. I liked the ride. It wasn't a bad ride. So I'm not, me giving it 3 doesn't mean it's a bad ride. If I'm comparing it to other rides, this is just a 3-star. But, he gave it a 3.8. I'm going to give it a 3. It's a solid 3. But it was fun. Definitely worth checking out, especially if you like dark rides or Alice in Wonderland. Definitely something for you. Alice's Adventures in Wonderland, or the Alice in Wonderland dark ride, 3 stars from me. So check it out. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this week's Disney news and reviews. Again, if anybody hasn't entered the giveaway yet, do so. Link is in the description box. You have one more week. Can't wait for Avengers. I'm going to be doing an Avengers kind of like marathon of movies. I might stream it, I'm not sure, but just keep out, any out for some videos on that. If I do, I'll let you guys know about it. And so that's pretty much it. Thanks again, John, for everything that you gave me here, or me and my brother, we are just in awe of everything, and you're just an awesome guy. So everybody, John is the man, and he is the man with the master plan. If anybody from Disney is watching, please don't sue me. I want people to go to Disney World or Disneyland and get on your rides and have a great time. Check out the Golden Zephyr if you want to. It's a good kids ride, not mainly meant for adults, but I see where you're going with that. But definitely check out the Alice in Wonderland ride. Nothing spectacular, but there's a lot of Disney history there. And especially if you're a fan of the dark rides and Alice in Wonderland, this is definitely something for you. So check that out. So if you are going to Disney World, be sure to go to rsnettouringplans.com, wdwmagic.com for our latest and greatest Disney news. WaltDisneyWorld.com is good too. So is Disneyland.com. They redid the sites and everything, so it looks really good. So yeah, I'll see you guys next week. It's going to be fun for the Avengers themed. It's the first weekend of movie month, so I'm really excited for that. I'm going to be talking about the Avengers, the new Avengers movie. And keep an eye out for some other videos I might be doing I might stream the marathon leading up to me going to the Avengers. I'm not sure, but we'll see how that works out. So yeah, I'll see you guys next week for another Disney news and reviews. And guys, where in the land am I this week? Bye guys.